What's going on, everyone? Alex De Silva, Happy as Larry Group. I hope you are well. Welcome to your daily dose of happiness. It's Friday. Christmas is almost here. And I just want to wish you, if I don't get to do another video, I just want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I will definitely do one for New Year's. I've got one planned. I've got one up my sleeve, which I'm going to share with you. But I just wanted to share some gratitude. I just wanted to share some success stories. I just wanted to share life. That's what these little videos are all about, you know. It's just sharing life, sharing, you know, successes, little small wins, big wins, you know. I think it's so important for us to be able to talk to each other, to be able to share these things. And primarily for me, I did a talk yesterday, and I was just sharing my experience, my life, where I've been through and you know, where I am today. And it's huge. You know, I always kind of take stock of my life. And I looked back, you know, at 2019, you know, there's been ups and downs. I think like everything in life, you know, you have your highs, you have your, you know, your bumps along the way. But one of the biggest takeaways for me is stay on course, keep going and just keep learning. I've learned LGD. Learn, grow, develop. Learn, grow, develop. Don't look at things as good, bad, ugly, you know, positive, negatives. Just look at everything as an experience. And every experience, take away the negative stuff, accept it, deal with it, discard it. And then take away the positives and use that moving forward. That is key. That is a lesson, huge lesson I've learned from this year, is take every single positive and just keep reapplying, keep growing, keep developing, and it's fantastic. I have my one-to-one with my coach. As you know, I've shared a number of times, I did CrossFit, and I've been training with him, and then I do some classes as well. And, you know, he did a bit of a test with me today on a workout that I did previously. And oh my God, it was gross. I've got to be honest, it was a disgusting workout. We did some lifting techniques, which was great. Upped my weight by 20 kilos, which was huge. Really, really good, but just kept focusing on technique. You know, we know that we can probably go a little bit higher, but it was really about the technique today. And, you know, and for me, that's what it's all about. It's about the basics, just keeping on top of the basics, just keeping on top of, you know, just fine line and everything, just really going for it. And, you know, had a great time, you know, really, really enjoyed it. And the last workout, which is one that we did before, I'll share it with you. If anybody has done CrossFit, or some of the people that do CrossFit who are watching this, it was 5 rounds for time, and it was 15 calories on the assault bike and 5 burpees. And then you rest a minute in between each round. And you want to do those rounds as quickly as you possibly can. It's not huge volume, but it's very, very quick. So you just want to get it done. And I smashed my time, which I was gobsmacked, by 1:17, which is huge, absolutely huge, compared to last time. And I want to share that, because for me, when I came out of that work, when my legs started working again and I was able to breathe and my lungs stopped burning and I held in, I was almost sick as well, but the gratitude, and I pat myself on the back and I said, well done, because that was tough. But the biggest thing that I took away from that is my improvement, you know, my ability to learn, to grow, to develop, you know, and just to keep pushing, just to get through those really, really tough times. First 3 rounds didn't feel too bad, but then as soon as I finished that third round, I knew I only had 2 more to go. Oh my God, the 4th and 5th was just horrible. It was awful. And I knew I had to just get through it. But I said to myself, you set a pace, you're going to stick with it. And that's what I did. And I sat with it and I stuck and I kept just pushing through. And, you know, he went through the times with me. And that's where I'm really, really proud. You know, I kind of kept, naturally, you're going to slow down because you get fatigued. But I stayed with it, you know. I didn't kind of decrease too much, and it proved. Look at my time, over 1 minute faster than what I did before. And he said to me, that's a round, you know, that's a full round quicker than I did the last time. So I want to share that, because Listen, you can apply this in life every single day. You can apply these things in everything, whether it's business, personal, whether you want to get fit, whether you want to change the way that you feel, the way you look, the way you think. It's applying the same principle. And the principle of that is just to be able to not give up, is to be able to not listen to this when it tells you to stop, is to be able to push through and just say, come on, I know that you can do this. Let me just see whether I can. And that is the proof in the pudding, because once you do something, the reward factor in your brain, you say to yourself, wow, I did it. Let's do another one. Wow, I did it. And then, as I said, when it got to that fourth round and I finished the fourth round, my lungs are burning by this point. I have a minute rest, and a minute goes very, very quickly when you're fatigued. But then I jump back on that bike and I said to myself, you are going to go all the way. You're going to go broke on this. And I did. I kind of stuck to my game plan. And wow, I was expecting 20 seconds, maybe, 10, but a minute 17 is huge. And that, for me, I came out just feeling I was over the moon. I was dying, but I was over the moon because, my goal for me personally, not a business, but just for me personally, is to improve every single day, is to give 120%, is to get out of that comfort zone that I have been in for so many years. But what I try to do is I do it slowly. I keep pushing myself, I take a step forward. Sometimes I may take two steps back. That's just natural part of life. It's not about being perfect. It's just about the journey. And that's what I've learned. And to see the improvement in less than a year, I'm talking a few months here. And even he looked at me and he said, that's a 20% increase on your fitness and that time. And it didn't really register because I was kind of dying a little bit, but it was such a huge achievement. And I want to share that with you because as we're going into another new year, it's very easy now. This is when we start to plan, we don't plan goals, we plan, the new year resolution. Yay, let's do something different in 2020. And nothing changes. And my wife always says it, if nothing changes, nothing changes. That stuck with me. It's almost like it's tattooed in my body, my brain, in my heart. And I remember it every time because it's so true. If we don't take a step forward, we're never going to change. Even if we take a step backwards to then go forward, that's change. We're doing something different. And that's what I've learned, is by doing something different, by pushing myself that little bit more. Do you know what it did for me? It helped me with my self-esteem. It proved to me that I can, that I'm worth it, that I am good enough. And it proved to me that I can go even more. And that, from somebody that came from nothing, that felt like he was never good enough, that I was never going to amount to anything, to be able to look back at these achievements, not just from today, but to look back the whole year of everything that we've achieved. Lucy and I are both running this business now full time, so you're going to see me even more now, and I'm going to share these videos even more with you to show you that everything is possible. But the thing that I realized is the accountability, the responsibility lies on me. My coach can show me everything, and he does. And I listen and I watch and I take everything he says seriously because I want to improve. But what I do is I take the same thing and I apply that into my business. And we do couples therapy, and there was a few things that I took away, and I'm trying to do that too, not to perfection, but just to change, because I don't want to be the same person I was this year. When I go into 2020, I'm going to smash 2020. I want to be completely different from 2019, even though 2019 has been absolutely phenomenal. So I want you to take that away. I want you to start to apply something different in your life. What can you do differently? What can you do differently? Let me know. Comment, like, subscribe, share. It's so important for us to keep growing and continuing us on this journey. Have an amazing day, evening, wherever you are in the world. I forgot to say afternoon as well, but there you are. Be great, be fantastic, and be absolutely phenomenal. Now go and eat loads of chocolate, enjoy Christmas, buy loads of presents, be with your family, and I will speak to you again very soon. Take care.